was far behind. I was no longer a child. I journeyed deep, deep within myself, deep within the earth, down to the Dene cavern. I was alone for a time as I consumed my heritage, breathing deep the air of the cavern and the knowledge of my people. But the desire for companionship drove me mad. I engaged a Senimar as my confidant, and a treadfish in the harbor became my younger brother. I spoke to them as family, and they answered. I swear, they answered. Then my mind took a final step into madness when I walked into the library on Agura and saw an old Dene man on the floor below me. Now I was imagining people to ease my loneliness. But he was no mirage. His name was Callum, and he was a Dene writer of ages. Trust did not come easily. There was conflict between us, between his ancient rules of Dene that I did not respect, and my creativity, which he feared. We fought and feared and battled and screamed until exhausted. We began to learn from each other. We learned of the power of both, just as father and mother had done. So I learned to write with all the skills that the Dene had known, beyond what my parents had taught me, for their lessons were given by a flawed instructor and by their own trial and error. I learned to write from a master, an opportunity father was never given. Callum's abilities were breathtaking. He knew all the Dene knew when Dene fell. But I taught as well as learned. There were things that the Dene were forbidden to write, words they feared, concepts they shunned, rules and boxes. I had no cultural fear of such things, so I dug deeper, asking questions that Callum could not answer. And together, we sought answers. That is how we learned of the Barrow and the Tablet. I learned of its power. We grew in knowledge and strength, and Callum became one of my dearest friends. I began to think that it was he who would be the grower. But evil will find you, even in the depths of the earth, when Callum was murdered. I learned of the fearsome power I wield on that day. The day of Callum's death. In a fit of rage, I destroyed the murderer and I destroyed my innocence. And again, I learned that most things cannot be returned to how they were. And my power continued to grow even as I began to see that the prophecies of the grower might speak of me. My destiny began to be fulfilled. But there was still more. The least, abused, mistreated, misunderstood, ignored. They were mocked and scorned, and their hearts still show their pain. But they continue to serve. Such power they have, and yet they serve. They treated me with kindness, and I learned from them. They respected what I was becoming. With them, I learned new laws, new rules, and new powers. I used the powers to care for a tree to come, and the tablet allowed me to grow beyond Tiana, beyond father and mother, beyond Dene, beyond Callum. The tablet held them. The tablet chained them. The tablet held me. The tablet empowered me. I watched with them. I waited with them. I learned with them. I called them from captivity and grew while they gathered. Together we became both weak and strong. And then my time came. My time to take the tablet. My time to choose. I was ready. I felt the pull of holding it, of channeling and releasing the full power of the Barrow. I would right the wrongs. I would set things the way they should be. I would choose well. I could not fail. I am the grower. I was so sure, so strong, so wise. But I didn't open myself and listen to the Maker. The noise of me drowned his quiet voice. And I failed. Failed to see anything beyond myself and what was obvious. And pain came quickly when I realized what I had done. The tablet returned and the Barrow continued to serve. The pain still burns me. But the powerful Barrow simply wait and serve. Pain is often how we learn. But it is not for us to give. We are not the teachers. We must not abuse them. We must not abuse the Barrow. What am I left with? Why did he leave this weight on me? Did I ask for this? Did I ask to lose my brothers? Did I ask to cause the death of Callum? Did I ask to watch my mother die? Did I ask to be my father's tool? Did I ask for so much power? Did I ask to be so alone? Father, I wish you could hold me. I know what to do. I see it so clearly. One more chance to determine the destiny of the tablet. I can feel it. To be so close and yet so powerless, it drives me mad. The tablet sits there, holding the power of the Barrow captive, and I alone know what to do. I failed once, but what does that mean? Why am I punished when I could accomplish so much? The rules seem so arbitrary, some game of the Maker that only he understands. This legacy of failure. And now I see this final chance to right generations of wrong. To unleash the power that has been held for thousands of years. It is at my fingertips. I know what must be done, but I cannot speak of it for fear that it would somehow break the rules, tarnish the heart, taint the act, soil the innocence. I had a dream. I am carrying the seed of Denis, the seed of all things that are Denis, through a small cave. I come to a place where the path stops. There are two holes, one above me and one below me. And through the hole below, I can see the Denis cavern and the great city. And through the hole above, I can see the sky and sun. A voice calls to me. In which hole will you plant the seed? And I know it is easy to drop the seed in the hole below. And I know it is impossible to throw the seed through the hole above. I call out to the voice asking for wisdom. And the voice answers me. Do not drop the seed in the hole below, for that is easy. But that is the way of the past. Do not throw the seed in the hole above, for that is difficult. And that is the task for another. In which hole will you plant the seed? And I know what to do. And I know. How could I have not seen the true path? I see it now so clearly. But can I get another chance to make things right? They came to Denis, those who felt cold. I knew they would. I was prepared for them, and I pointed the way. I spoke often of the pride of Denis, of their belief in their own power and strength, and the reason that Denis once fell. And a few understand, and they begin to follow me. I am the grower. I would lead them to rebuild. Yet another burden. But what is the task of a grower? My father wrote another age, but I see that the tree is not a place, but a people. The heart of a people. That is what must grow. If only I had another chance to make things right. The tablet is the key. How could I have failed?
I wish you could see Lachian as I remember it. Anticipation. The calls of the beasts bellowing out over the warm airs. And conversations as we waited for the fires to burn. The battle to begin. This was a place of great strength and triumph. I wonder if you possess such courage. The door to the trade house is locked, but the jeweler door on the other side, that can be unlocked.
Power is a gift. Power is a curse.